Do you ever do 30-100 breaststroke?
I have done 30-100 breaststroke on 130.
30-100 breaststroke on 1 minute 30 seconds. That's what I used to do for my freestyle.
So, Sandeep, after having missed out on the Commonwealth Games, so how important is the Asian Games for you?
See, even if I wouldn't have missed out on the Commonwealth Games, I think the Asian Games was my prime target from last 3 years. I've been training for the Asian Games particularly because, you know, that's where I've already won a medal before, and I think I could do better than a bronze medal in the Asian Games. So that's what my focus was.
Okay. So considering you won the 50 meter this thing at the Singapore championship, so how big a confidence booster is it for you?
Well, to win a medal at the international stage always is a big motivation for any swimmer or any athlete for that matter, and also that win came at the exactly right time when I needed one, and with only 1.5 months before the Asian Games, if you win a major competition like that, it definitely is a very good motivator for me.
So, you have always been a breaststroke swimmer across three lengths, like 50, 100 and 200. So, will you be competing in all three this time, or are you targeting
just
one?
No, I am only targeting the 50, but okay. I will be trying out for the 100 as well. Okay. But my training has been only focused for the 50 meters.
Okay. So, how is it that you train for, say, the sprint races as you get older? It said that your speed reduces. So, considering you are concentrating on the shortest this thing, so how do you train for it?
I think the best way to train for the 50 is to focus more on the recovery, because there are it's mostly the power event, so I'm working a lot harder in the gym what I used to do earlier, and building strength to take me to another level in terms of body to strength ratio. I think that has been going on very well for me, so I think 50, as you get older, because of the recovery factor also comes in, so I am not really recovering that much for the 100 and the 200, so that's why my focus is only for the 50.
Considering you have a medal already at the Asian Games, does it give you an edge over the others?
No, I don't think so, because that medal was 4 years back, and this Games comes once in 4 years, and there have been a lot of swimmers who've been swimming really well. So I wouldn't say that it gives me an edge, but it definitely gives me confidence to race against the same countries that I've raced before. So yeah, other people are also swimming really fast. I've been tracking my performance, and along with other Japanese and Chinese swimmers. So I think this year everyone is going really neck to neck, and when it comes to Asian Games or any big games, it's about handling the pressure. Whoever handles the pressure best is going to be better at the end of the day.
Who do you think your biggest competitors are?
Well, my biggest competition for sure is me, myself, because at this age to compete at that level is very difficult, especially to train for that kind of an event. So I'm really focused on the recovery, and right so far the preparation has been going on very well. So I hope I can better myself, better my own performance in the Asian Games.
So you have, like you mentioned, across three lengths. So what is the mindset that goes into training for each one of those? Can you explain?
Well, it's completely different. It's like if you take athletics, 100 meter sprinters train only for the 100 meters, and marathon swimmers will run for a longer time. So same thing happens in swimming. So if you're training for only for the 50, you got to work harder in the gym, and there are less meters to be done in the swimming pool. And if you're training for the 100 and the 200, the meters in the swimming pool goes up, and the load of gym comes down a little bit. So it's completely different, and one is pure power for the 50, and 100 and 200 is completely endurance.
So when you go into a big tournament like this, so how is your preparation? What is that you focus on, specifics?
See, like I told you, I've been training for this competition for the last 3 years, so preparation has been going on very well. Right now, I'm entering my final phase of training, which is tapering. So I think right now I would only have to do is keep my mind a little more focused, because there is nothing I can do from now till the Asian Games which will change my physical appearance or my physical strength that much. So only thing I can change is my mental mindset. So I've been working on that.
So is there anything specific you do, something in terms of mentally preparing yourself?
Only focusing and visualizing every day. There are a lot of things that we do, but then I think it's the experience of 20, almost 20 years that I've been competing, that is going to come into picture, and it's going to help me to be better at the Asian Games.
And how valuable is it having someone like Nihar Emin on your side?
Well, he's the best coach I've met or ever trained with, and I've traveled around the world to train with a lot of different coaches. So, and also I've been training with him for 13 years, so our chemistry is very good. So he knows exactly what I need and what my weaknesses are. So we've been working on those, and hopefully, Asian Games, everything will fall out in place.
Do you know, go back to a few of your videos, assess what is going right, what is going wrong?
We definitely do that, but then right now it's not the time to, you know, find the mistakes and to correct them. Right now it's only time to focus on our strengths. We've been working on our weakness for a very long time. So I think we've got all the weak areas covered. Now I think we're just ready to race and just give our body the enough rest that it requires and to perform well at the games.
Swimming is a sport of where records get broken quite easily. So are you happy with the progression in timings that you have achieved in these 3 years that have been preparing?
Well, I've been very happy with the performance that I gave in the Singapore Open. So I think everything that I've done before that had come right into place for that Singapore Open. So we are just trying to replicate the same performance that we got in Singapore Open to match up or be maybe a tenth of a second faster in the Asian Games.
So you've been training at the Padukone Academy now, and considering you told that you try to visualize situations, so these are facilities that are coming up recently. So how important are they in replicating some of the standards that you get worldwide?
See, right now we've got a world-class standard swimming pool. We've got world-class gym. We've got very high-tech equipments in Abhinav Bindra Targeting Performance Center that we are using for our rehabs and all that. So especially the blocks that we are using in Padukone Dravid Center is helping my start, because start was my weakest link. Now I've been working for 8 months almost just on my starts, which I'm feeling very confident about right now. So I think all these kind of infrastructure do help, because earlier we were not getting used to any starting blocks of world standard. Now that we have one, we don't have any reasons to complain.
So I just wanted to curious to know, like, this is all great for Indian sport, upcoming swimmers. So for you personally, did you wish that it had come a few years earlier?
I would have definitely loved it to be there for almost since when I started, but then better late than never. So I think there are a lot of young swimmers who've got potential and who's got a lot of time to train, so I think they can use these world class facilities and make maximum out of them and get better.
Recently at the Singapore thing, we saw Veer Dhawan actually overcome Joseph Schooling in 100 meter freestyle. So though it was not the pet event for Schooling, how big is a win like that by an Indian? Does it inspire everybody around who is competing there?
It definitely inspires, because beating a world champion, beating an Olympic medalist, is always a motivation for yourself. And if all the teammates are watching, they also get to know that it is possible to beat an Olympic champion when he is not at his best shape. So that definitely gives the whole team good motivation and positive vibes that if one can do it, why can't other people do it?
So one thing about the competition at the Asian Games, so we have competition from the Japanese and Chinese swimmers, whereas in the Commonwealth Games we have from the British these nations. So can you compare the standards of competition, how it will be?
Well, Japan has got a few world record holders in the breaststroke events. So that's me talking about my breaststroke event. So and we've got an Olympic medalist from Kazakhstan who recently won a gold medal at the Olympics. He's also going to be competing at the Asian Games. So for me, I would say breaststroke events, it is as good as an Olympics or as good as a world championship when it comes to Asian Games. But other events, I think sprint event, India's got a very good chance. Mm-hmm. And there are a lot of kids like Sri Hari, Sajan Prakash, who are really doing very good in middle distance also. So I think this is the best team that India is sending for the Asian Games.
So personally, what is the target that you have set to yourself?
Personally, my target is, because since we have already won a medal at the Asian Games before this, so my only aim is to go and enjoy another Asian Games. And in that enjoying process, if we get a few podium finishes, that will be great.
So career-wise, how long are you looking ahead?
See, right now my mental control is only till the Asian Games. I'm only focusing on the Asian Games, and I'm seriously not sure what I'm going to be doing after Asian Games. So depending on the performance of Asian Games, if I get selected for other big competitions, I might continue training. Otherwise, for me, it looks like at the international stage, it could be the last international.
So you want to go out on a high, if at all?
Yeah, I definitely would want to end it on a high note, and more than ending it on a high note, I would like to be, you know, I would like to enjoy the racing experience for maybe one last time and see how it works.
So what next?
So what next is same, depends on the Asian Games performance. Mostly I'm planning to shift to coaching. So, but that's a long-term plan. I don't know when I'm going to start that, but definitely coaching is next, and hopefully I could swim for, if I can swim for another few years, then till 2020, that will be great.